Pinnacle Studio is a great program for both beginner and advanced users wanting to create their own slideshows or videos. In this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through how to set up your first project. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here, you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along. Let's get started. Once you open Pinnacle Studio, click on File, New, then Movie. This will open up a new timeline where you can start building your slideshow or video. First, we want to build a project bin with all the media we're going to use for this project. Go to the left and click on the Project Bin icon. Then select the Create a New Project Bin icon. A small dialog box will pop up asking you to name your new project bin. I'm going to name mine Family Fun Slideshow. Now a new project bin has been created and we can add our media. One way to do this is to click on the Quick Import icon. From here, you can browse to the file folder that contains your images and drag to select your media. Then click Open. Alternatively, if you have a file folder open on your computer that contains your chosen media, you can left-click to highlight the media you want to add, then drag and drop it directly into your project bin. Now that we have gathered the assets we want to use, we can make some adjustments to the default settings of our project. To do this, go to Setup, then select Control Panel. Now click on Project Settings. Here, you will be able to adjust all your default movie project settings. Under New Movie Project Format, you can select your video's default resolution. You can also select the option to automatically detect the video format from the first clip added to the project and use that as a default for the rest of your movie. Next, we can change the default durations. You can adjust how many seconds for the default duration for new titles, stills, and transitions. There's also an option to enable or disable ruler zooming, so you can zoom up on your timeline. I like to keep it enabled. In the Control Panel, you can also customize import settings. Click on Import. Here you can change the default storage locations for media and projects that are physically copied when you use the importer. You can change the default video, audio, image, and project directory by clicking on the Browse button and selecting a new folder. Once you have selected a base folder, you can optionally set up a subfolder. You can create a subfolder names with the current date, today, by creation date, current month, or select custom to name your own subfolder. Now let's click on the Storage Locations tab to set where to save media and projects that you create. Here you can change the default locations for the projects you are working on in Pinnacle Studio, including your movie projects, disc projects, titles, and more. To change where you'd like these projects to be stored, simply click on the Browse folder to select a new folder. Finally, let's click on the Startup Page tab. Here you can select which workspace tab will display when you launch Pinnacle Studio, such as the Edit tab. By default, the Welcome tab is open. I suggest keeping the Welcome screen as your default startup page, since it has new content all the time, including new Pinnacle Studio tutorials, special offers, new filters, and more. Once you're happy with your settings, click Apply. Then click OK. And now you are ready to start creating your project. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can find more Pinnacle Studio tutorials that will teach you the basics of creating movies and slideshows, as well as more advanced video projects and special effects.